tick-tock, 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 tick-tock.
Oh, if there was just something to do.
Yeah, just a second. Nick! More Dear Nicks for ya! Dear Nicks!
I keep hearing you're concerned about my happiness, but all that thought you're giving me is conscience, I guess.
Howdy everyone, welcome back to the Dear Nick. I'm really happy to be here. I've been working around the world, you know, creating goodness, spreading love and joy. But that's beside the point, we'll get to that in another show. This show, we've got a couple of Dear Nick questions, and I would be happy to answer them. First question is, Dear Nick, where do Smurfs come from? Peter LaRue, grade 7. Thank you for asking this question, Peter. It's got kind of a tragic story to it, but that's okay. To start things off, Smurfs were devised in the mind of the Belgian artist Peyo. They became very popular in the French culture, where they were called Strumpfs, probably based on the German word for socks. They became very popular in the French culture, and some say even national icons. So they were brought over to the American audience. Now, I believe that they were brought over by right-wing French nationalists who wanted to use the Smurfs as a vehicle to take over the American economy and government. What the French failed to do, however, was properly translate the word Smurfs. What happened was, when they were translating it, they failed to recognize the fact that plural words that end in F have a V-E-S ending. So, the three apple tall guys that we all know and love, the ones we call Smurfs, it should actually be Smurves. When you get right down to it, if it wasn't for the French, their blatant ignorance of the English language, we would all be speaking French right about now. Alright, here we go. Why are there so many shots with Nathan Hall? He is in almost every show, and I'm getting tired of him. Sarah Maddings, grade 12. You've got a good eye, viewer. As the popularity of the Where's Waldo books, published by French nationalists, grows, we here at STV decided to play a little game. We like to call it Spot the Nathan.
And now, because we're trying to take up as much time as possible, here's our top 10, which has been called Stupendous, Fantastic, Superb.
Nathan helped Jed with his anchor shots.
Terrific, thrilling, enchanting, delightful, a triumph, entertaining, astounding, amazing, uncanny, astonishing, spectacular, and good. In short, every adjective...
Nathan was also hiding in one of our top tens.
This is good. Man, this is cool. Just roll the tape. Roll it.
Where's Nathan? Where is he? There he is!
Hi, this is Hallway Talk with Jamie Hughes.
He also stepped in for Jamie during Hallway Talk. A lot of people spotted him there.
There you go. Sarah, believe me, we've learned our lesson, and we know better than to favor our friends and our shows. Well, that wraps it up for this week. Thanks for the questions. Back to you, Liam.